官员也会针对台湾关台美关系交换意见。很高兴这次能在台湾跟议长见面。
I would like to extend a very warm welcome to Speaker Pelosi and the delegation. In our previous transit stop in the United States, Vice President Lai and I have always received calls from the Speaker to welcome us and exchange views with us on Taiwan-US relations. I am delighted to meet face-to-face with the Speaker in Taiwan this time.
Pelosi 议长是台湾最坚定的友人，各位议员也都是美国众议院重要的领袖，长期在各领域积极推动台美关系的进展。非常感谢各位此次来台访问，展现出美国国会对台湾坚固长期的支持。
Speaker Pelosi is truly one of Taiwan's most devoted friends. The representatives here today are all important leaders in the House.
Important to remind some and inform others of how we are here. 43 years ago, with the Taiwan Relations Act, America made a bedrock promise to always stand with Taiwan. And on this strong foundation, we have built a thriving partnership, grounded in our shared values of self-government and self-determination, focused on our mutual security interests in the region and across the world, committed to the economic ties that power prosperity for all of our people.
我这一次的来访呢，其中一项重点就是要提醒大家并告知大家，43年前我们通过了台湾关系法，当时就许下了对台湾非常坚定的承诺，要与台湾站在一起。在这个基础之上，我们形成了非常繁荣的合作关系跟伙伴关系。我们的焦点不但是有包括我们的共同命运的自觉，还有许多我们共同安全的议题，无论是在这个地区还是全世界的共同安全，以及我们必须要保障我们，并且深化我们的经济关系，使得我们的两国的人民能够有更好的生活。
Today, our delegation, I'm very proud, came to Taiwan to make unequivocal clear we will not abandon our commitment to Taiwan, and we are proud of our enduring friendship. And may I mention, they're all co-chairs of this delegation. The chair of the Foreign Affairs Committee, Mr. Gardner from New York. The chair of the Foreign Affairs Committee, Mr. Takano, California. The vice chair of the Ways and Means Committee, Congressman Galbano of Washington State. The member of the Intelligence Committee and a leader in COVID fighting and so many things in the Congress, Congressman Raja Krishnamurti from Illinois, he's from Chicago. And again, one of our newest members of Congress, serving the diplomat, as a diplomat in the State Department before coming, Congressman Andy Kim, of not only the Armed Services Committee, but also the Foreign Affairs Committee and others. We're very proud of our delegation, and when you hear, as you, what you're hearing from them in the course of our visit, you will know even more why we are. Thank you to our delegation. And we're proud to be here with the Vice President, with Mr. Wu, with other distinguished leaders who are here with you, Madam President. Thank you for your leadership. The story of Taiwan is an inspiration to all freedom-loving people in the United States and around the world. Out of a crucible of challenge, you have forged a flourishing democracy, one of the freest in the world, proudly to be led by a woman president. That's an applause now.
Well, this is a very honored to come to Taiwan. We have to express our very clear expressions of our commitment to Taiwan. We will not abandon our promise.这次来访的许多议员们，他们也都是在各委员会当中担任主席或副主席或其他的要职，例如说外交委员会的主席李克斯、政府军人事务委员会的主席高武、会计委员会的副主席戴碧妮、情报委员会以及防疫许多方面的贡献者特里蒂纳莫吉、军事委员会以及外交委员会的成员金安吉等等，他们都非常荣幸能够来到台湾，也非常感谢这些议员们跟我随行一起来访。那我也很高兴，也很荣幸 能够在这边见到副总统、吴部长以及蔡总统，以及非常许多杰出的台湾的政治领导者，非常感谢各位的领导。那台湾的故事呢，其实就是一群热爱自由民主的人民的故事。那其实我们在美国，在全世界都有许多这样子热爱自由的人民。
And Taiwan has been an island of resilience in the world. Indeed, the people of Taiwan have proven to the world that with hope, courage, and determination, it is possible to build a peaceful and prosperous future, even in terms of the challenges you face. And now, more than ever, America's solidarity with Taiwan is crucial, and that is the message we are bringing here today.
台湾是一个韧性之岛，台湾的人民也向外界证明了，只要有希望、有勇气、有决心，一定能够打造一个和平又繁荣的未来。尽管台湾面临着这么多的严峻的挑战，但美国与台湾的团结也非常的重要。我们这一次来访就是要向外界彰显像这样子的美台之间的团结。
When we travel and leave the country as a congressional delegation, security.Protect our people as well as global security, economy to spread prosperity in our own country and others, and governments are three principal pillars of our travel. In all three areas, we have great cooperation and friendship with Taiwan, and we value that. I just do want to mention and congratulate Taiwan for your governance of the COVID issue, the COVID pandemic.You're a model to the world in terms of the cooperation of the people and the success of your initiative. Congratulations, Madam President. Congratulations to the people of Taiwan for following the lead and suggesting their own proposal. Today, the world faces a choice between democracy and autocracy. America's determination to preserve democracy here in Taiwan and around the worldremains ironclad. And we're grateful to the partnership of the people of Taiwan in this mission. I'm very grateful to receive this award. I'm grateful to you, Madam President, to the people, for their enduring friendship. I'm very blessed, as are my colleagues, with many Taiwan Americans who are very excited about our visit. And in fact, when I came before, in 99, I came with them. And we learned a lot, and that's what we came to do, to participate in the Asian Pacific Initiative in a way that is appropriate for Taiwan to be successful, whether in trade, security, et cetera, and to do so in a way that opens many more possibilities. We came here to listen, to learn, and what do you know?I got this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful award. The Order of Propitious Clouds, the special grand program. Thank you, Madam President. Thank you so much.
这一次我们访问亚洲各国，我们有三大支柱，三个主要的重点，一个就是安全，人民的安全，全球的安全，经济，也就是说我们要创造未来的繁荣，能够加惠更多的人，以及我们治理。好的治理，这是我们此次访问的三大支柱。那我们这一次呢，也都跟台湾这些在这三个领域当中都有许多的合作。我们也非常重视跟台湾在这些领域当中的伙伴关系。我们也要特别向台湾的人民以及台湾的政府去恭贺台湾在防疫方面的所有的成就。台湾的防疫真的是全世界的一个模范，可以彰显台湾人民的合作、台湾防疫政策的成功等。现在我们全世界面临着两个选择，选择民主或者选择威权。那美国致力于保障台湾以及全世界的民主，我们像这样子的决心是非常坚定不移的。我也非常感谢这次总统给我颁赠的勋章，以及总统以及许多的台湾的领导阶层给我彰显的许多非常热诚的友谊。我也看到许多美国在台湾的侨民都非常的兴奋看到我们的到来。的确1999年我那次来访的时候也学到很多，我们也在立法的殿堂当中也致力了非常多许多亚裔美国人，还有你说去跟台湾之间发展更多紧密的贸易关系等的许多的工作， 我们都持续的在推展，这些工作的推展能够开启更多的可能性，让我们能够有更多的机会互相学习，这就是我们的来意，互相学习。而且呢，除了互相学习之外，还获得了非常美丽的奖章，大寿青年勋章，非常感谢总统。
接下来进行合影，总统、副总统、梅洛西议长、ANT 处长及各位众议员合影。
Madam President, Mr. Vice President, Madam Speaker, distinguished members of the House of Representatives, please come together for a group photo. We now welcome all guests to join us for a group photo.
This concludes this